সম্মানিত দর্শক, বিরতির পর আবারও লাইভ ট্রাভেল গাইড অনুষ্ঠানে আপনাদেরকে স্বাগত। এই মুহূর্তে আপনারা যারা টিভি স্ক্রিনের সামনে এসেছেন, আপনাদেরকেও আমি আমন্ত্রণ জানাচ্ছি আমাদের লাইভ ট্রাভেল গাইড অনুষ্ঠান দেখার জন্য। আর আজকের টপিকটা হলো হাউ টু পারফর্ম হাজ। আর আমরা আলাপ করতেছিলাম হজের মধ্যে কতটা ফরজ এবং ওয়াজিব। আমি কথা না বলিয়ে সরাসরি মৌলানা রায়হান আহমদের কাছে চলে যাচ্ছি। এই যে আমরা বলেছিলাম দুইটা ফরজ আর একটা ফরজ আর ওয়াজিবগুলো বাকি আছে, তো আপনারা দেখতেই থাকুন, উনি ফরজগুলো এবং ওয়াজিবগুলোর কথা বলবেন। মৌলানা রায়হান, বি কন্টিনিউ প্লিজ।
ওকে, চল। সো
লাস্ট ফরজটা বাকি ছিল।
সো লাস্ট ফরজ হলো গাম, ইটস তওয়াফ জিয়ারা, ইউ কল ইন ইংলিশ তওয়াফ।
হোয়াট ইজ দ্য তওয়াফ জিয়ারা?
তওয়াফ জিয়ারা ইজ বেসিক্যালি অন দ্য 10th অফ জুলহিজ্জা। সো ইউ আর ইন মিনা রাইট নাও। সো হোয়াট হ্যাপেন আফটার মুজদালিফা, you go to through the Mina. So when you do Hajj, you'll know you go through Mina and you do the pelting, and after the pelting,
big shaitan,
all right, be a big
seven stones.
And then after that, what you're supposed Kurbani. To do is the sacrifice. And then after that, we shave our heads. And after that, we are out of ihram, except relationship with our wife. And then finally, the fourth action on that day, the suitability, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it easy for us, is you can do on the 10th, 11th,
or 12th. Before sunset.
Yeah, before sunset. So this is the last fard, you can say a pillar of Hajj.
Tawaf-e-Ziyara. But you know there is before the Tawaf-e-Ziyara, like pelting shaitan and shaving and kurbani, shaving, it is serial wajib or we can do here and there after, before?
Now, it's an interesting question. I think our viewers need to be clear in this. Now, obviously, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his method was that he did this order. So all the imams, all the scholars, past and present, they believe that it's sunnah, it's something great. Now, some scholars, like the Hanafi scholars, mainly Imam Abu Hanifa, his research, shows that it's not just an optional thing that is really good to do, but in fact his evidence shows, and there are lots of hadith that we can speak to our imams and scholars for that. They will elaborate more on this, that we have to keep this order is wajib.
Whether order is the first pelting shaitan, then kurbani, then is shaving head, then you go to the tawaf-e-ziyara.
Order is wajib, but there are many other scholars. Even some Hanafi scholars, they say that it's sunnah, and especially nowadays it's very difficult. So only few scholars, they give this leeway because of the situation now. But I think it is possible to keep the order.
And can you tell us quick how many wajib?
Now wajibs are of approximately 22.
Okay.
The wajibs are there in place, but just how different ulama, they categorize something. Some people break one wajib into two wajibs. Just to explain to people. So I have one here which is taken from a very famous book called Mukhtasar al-Quduri, which is mainly on Hanafi laws.
Hanafi schools.
Hanafi school of thought. So I'm just going to very quickly go through it. Those important ones I'll explain inshallah. Okay. So we had three, the fard of Hajj. Now the wajibats are, number one, staying in Muzdalifah. We know on the 9th after the Arafah, everyone goes to Muzdalifah. To make it for Muzdalifah, Muzdalifah's time is from the dawn till the sunrise. So you have to have some moment there, minimum. So at least for a moment. So that's the first wajib.
Then from Subah Sadiq to the sunrise.
Sunrise.
We should in be. Between that time, some moment.
Yeah, sunnah is to stay all the way. Yeah. Because that was the way.
All night or whatever.
But at least for a moment to get this tick.
Clear. Done.
Then number two, we have Sa'i. So you know, after the Tawaf, people do Safa Marwa, going up and down, the long one. So that one. So one important note is that we have to do that by walking, unless we have some excuse. Just because
getting... Serious illness.
Yeah, if someone gets a little bit illness, the whole thing is we're supposed to feel it. Look at the history of this. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved the action of Hajara, the wife of Ibrahim alayhi salam, when she was looking for water. Because remember, it's for the sake of Allah, she stayed in this barren place. There was nothing happening there. And then she was looking for water, going up and down, up and down, up and down. Finally, when Jibril alayhi salam came, when Zamzam started, Allah loved her action so much that he has made compulsory on the men to do her actions. So this shows Islam values women. If someone does something great, it doesn't matter if they are men or women, Allah values their actions. Although ladies don't have to do that, but women have to copy her actions. So subhanAllah, it became, it's not just option, but it's actually wajib, is one of the main requirements of Umrah, any sort of Hajj. Then we have pelting the Jamarat. So we have the three stones, and I'm sure we know the history of that when Shaitan came to deceive Ismail alayhi salam, and that's when they threw things at him, and that's why we do that. So one thing to remember, Shaitan is not actually there. It is very symbolic. We're doing that to show that we hate to Shaitan. Ibrahim alayhi salam, our prophet. And plus, spiritually, we have this thing that we don't like you, Shaitan.
Yeah.
We're showing you in action.
But we have to kill our
Shaitan inside us.
Yeah.
That's more important. Yeah. May Allah help us. But that's the biggest struggle.
Yeah.
So that's one important thing. And then we have to remember we throw little pebbles, you know, our sandals or anything like that.
Like chickpeas.
Yes.
If it's very small, then problem, what's happening, Mulana? You can't go very close. Then you have to a little bit far. But if it's very thin, then it will be a fly. But that's why I think so is a chickpeas size chickpeas, will be good. Yeah.
So you can call them pebbles, small pebbles. And then it's good to collect them from Muzdalifa area, if it's possible, but not from right next to the Jamarat, because these are probably used by other people.
Yeah.
Then after that we have Tawaf of leaving, which is called?
Tawaf Bida.
So that's when we are bidding farewell to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the people who come from outside.
Yes.
It's wajib for them, they should do that. Then we have cutting or shaving of the head. So that's actually wajib. Although it's not fard, our hajj will still be done. We'll have to give penalty for it. We'll have to sacrifice animal for that. But it is wajib. It is very important. Then we have not delaying, not going past the miqat. It's wajib that we must do our ihram by the miqat. And if we miss that, we have to go back. So it's very important that we know this fard as well. Wajib as well. Then after that, number seven, we have keeping away from all the transgressions of ihram. So for example, in ihram, we're not allowed to cut our nails, we're not allowed to put perfume on, we're not allowed to have relationship with our partners, so we have to stay away from that. Right? It's actually, it's wajib, it's compulsory that we don't do those things. We have to abstain from them. Wearing like garments like that, sewn. Then number eight is Arafah day. Although just going for Arafah for a moment is fard, but to stay there until sunset is wajib. That's why we'll see all the people that stay there, and after sunset we'll see the queues. Yeah. Then we have number nine, delaying Maghrib and Isha until Muzdalifah. So we know that we go there and pray Maghrib and Isha together in Muzdalifah. And number 10, not delaying the Tawaf of visiting beyond the days of Nahar.
I have to go to one call. Let's go see to the who is there tonight. Hello, caller. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam. Assalamu alaikum.
Kya bolchen bhai? Kuta theke bolchen?
Ami Mohammad Kona ami London theke bolchi.
Ha bhai, apnar prashno ta bolben.
Prashno hole apnar to Hajj somonde alap korra.
Ji. Amader topic ta holo Hajj ki rokom korte hobe.
Ji amar. আমার প্রশ্নটা হইল যে ওই যে শেখ হজর পয়সা হজর সাজ বড়ইনার হজর পয়সা মারি দিয়ে এরা কিতা কিতা অবস্থা একটু কইবানি প্লিজ
ঠিক আছে আমরা যদি সময় আমাদের যদি সময় থাকে তাহলে এটা আমাদের টপিকের মধ্যে না বা টপিকের বাইরে আমাদের যদি সময় থাকে শেষের দিকে তাহলে আমরা অবশ্য এটা আনসার দিতে চেষ্টা করব ধন্যবাদ আপনার প্রশ্ন রাখার জন্য
বলে বলতে ওই যে শেখ হজর ব্যবসা বড়ইনার পয়সা
Thank you. Thank you. Inshallah, Amra Vishwa Chasta Gobo, Shashir Dige Bolarjino. Molana, we have to finish the wajib things.
Yeah, we'll finish wajib, inshallah. First. So, number 10, we have we shouldn't delay the tawaf of ziyara beyond the days of Ayamun Nahar. Ayamun Nahar are 10th, 11th.
I think we have to keep quick because we have four minutes left.
Inshallah. Then after that we have number 11, beginning Tawaf from the Hajar al-Aswad. We start from there. Then number 12, performing Tawaf counterclockwise. We go around this, so we don't do the other way.
Yeah, anti-clockwise.
Anti-clockwise, yes. Number 13, performing Tawaf around the Hatim. So you know the space where people try to rush and pray Salah in there. we have to go around that because that's part of the Kaaba.
Outside the Hatim wall.
We have to go outside the Hatim
wall. Not inside Hatim wall.
Walking in Tawaf for those who have no excuse. So if you're able, you walk in Tawaf. You don't get a wheelchair for no reason. Then after the number 15, being in the state of purity, meaning we have to have wudu, we have to be fully pure for Tawaf. Number 16, we should wear, cover our satr. All right, so for women, we know all our body except for our face and her hands. And for men, we have to make sure that we cover from belly button to the knees. And this is important, why? Because there was a time before Islam, some Arabs used to perform Tawaf naked. Somehow they had this understanding that this is a right devotion to, and this is some sort of respect to the Kaaba. So this is not allowed, and this doesn't happen anyway. And number 17, performing two rakats after Tawaf.
Wajib al-Tawaf.
Then after that we have beginning, you know, the Sa'i should begin from Safa, then Marwa. Inna Safa wal Marwa. And we have number 19, walking in Sa'i as well. For those people who have no excuses, wajib for them to walk. If they just sit around on wheelchairs or automatic ones, they'll have to give penalty for that. And number 20, performing Sa'i after a valid Tawaf. So you can't just go and start performing Sa'i from nowhere. We have to do a Tawaf before that. And number 21, slaughtering an animal for one performing tamattu or qiran, that's wajib for them. So this we mentioned that is for shukr and is for thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but it's not one of those shukr that, you know, we do it when we want to, but we have to do this shukr. And then finally, we have to maintain the order, as we mentioned before, on the Yawmun Nahar, on the 10th, where we have to pelt first, then after that we have to do the qurbani slaughter, then after that we cut our hair, and then we can do Tawaf Ziyarah.
Jazakallah, Maulana. I have to go to caller again. Hello, caller. Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum. Bun ke bolchen kotha theke bolchen?
Ami London theke bolchi. Amar naam Sufia. Ami jante chai husband and wife jodi hoje jan te wife er chul ke katiye dibe, husband er katiye dibe ki chul una chul katar pore ghusl korar pore na ghusl er age chul katiye ashe dilei hobe na uni ghusl kore tar pore dibe ar koto tuku katte hobe eta jante chai.
Okay, dhonnobad apnar prashno rakhar jonno.
Apni assalamu alaikum.
Apni shunun, ei jokhon chul katar shomoy hoye jabe তখন আপনার স্বামী আপনার চুল কাটতে পারবে অথবা আপনার সঙ্গে যে মহিলা থাকবে মহিলার সঙ্গে যদি আপনি থাকেন তো ওই সময় আরেকজন মহিলাও আপনার চুল কাটতে পারবেন আর চুলটা হলো আমাদের হাতের আঙ্গুলের মধ্যে একটা রাউন্ড সার্কুলার মতো হলে হয়ে যাবে অথবা সিলেটি কথা বলে যে এক কর এতটুকু যারা আমার শিবিতে দেখতেছেন এক কর পর্যন্ত কাটলেই হবে আপনার চুল সব যখনই হারাম পড়বেন তো মাথার উপরের দিকে ওইদিকে চুল নিয়ে সবগুলোকে পিছনে নিয়ে বেঁধে রাখবেন যাতে আপনার সব চুলের গোড়া থেকে এক কর পর্যন্ত কাটা হয় ধন্যবাদ মোলানা ইজ উই হ্যাভ টু টক অ্যাবাউট দ্য ইউ নো দ্য ইজ ইন এ পিরিয়ড লাইক দ্য তোয়াফে জিয়ারা বাট যে সময় মহিলাদের অসুস্থ হয়ে যায় যেটা মান্তি সার্কুল বলা হয় ওই সময় কি করা তার তখন যখন তোয়াফে জিয়ারত করবেন আর সেই সময় ওনার মান্থলি সার্কুল শুরু হয়েছে একটু বলবেন সংক্ষেপে একটু সংক্ষেপে
সো ভেরি সিম্পলি যে তার মাসিক যে এটা অসুবিধা হয় এটা বিকজ তোয়াফ করতে হইলে ইফ ইউ ওয়ান্ট টু ডু তোয়াফ জিয়ারা বিকজ ইউ গোয়িং ইন দ্য মসজিদ
ইয়া
উই হ্যাভ টু বি ফ্রি ফ্রম অল টাইপস অফ হাদাস which is janabat if someone needs ghusl because they need ghusl that time and they can't do come out there until it's over So this becomes a big problem. Going in the masjid is actually haram that time. So the standard masla is originally what they have to do is wait. They have to wait until the period is over, the cycle is over, then they can come and do the tawaf ziyara. This is the normal masala. Now we have a big problem today, and I'm sure those people with experience of Hajj, they all know there is no easy. It's booked from before. The return is booked as well. And then we have all these other complications.
Hotel also is booked.
Hotel is booked. You can't just sit like olden days, camp out anywhere and just wait and go back
slowly. Somebody will come back again. You have to go out.
We have to go out again. So because of this reason, we are in a sort of like a dilemma. So the ulamas have thought a lot and they found some solutions. So we have one solution where, and this is not to be used normally, that there are some medication the sisters could use where that would stop their bleeding. And which means they are technically out of that state, they could have a shower quickly. That's the last resort. On the last moment they should do this. and then they could go and do
tawaf and ziyarah.
And the other way is if somebody doesn't want to do that, because that would can medically affect them.
Health-wise,
because it's stopping a natural cycle. It's not natural to do this. And what they can do is they have a shower and they wrap themselves up properly and they go straight to the masjid, last thing, on the last moment. They don't do this too early. And they do the tawaf and come out and they have to...
They do sacrifice.
Sacrifice.
What? Camel?
A camel.
Okay, জাযাকাল্লাহ মাওলানা সম্মানিত দর্শক আবারও আমাকে একটা বিরতিতে যেতে হচ্ছে আপনারা আমাদের সঙ্গেই থাকুন বিরতির পর আবারও কথা হবে দেখা হবে